Hey YouTube, hey Diamond Gang. I just wanted to talk a little bit in this video about good health, also about the end times. I know I had a mukbang on here where I was talking about the end times, and a lot of you really liked that video, so I just want to touch on a little bit of that. Also, and y'all, I have a ring light now, so yeah, it's a really good ring light that I'm using. Also, now that I have this ring light, I'm gonna probably be doing a lot more videos now that I have this ring light. But y'all, what I wanted to talk about a little bit was the fact that I had a video on my top 5 favorite YouTubers, and I left out a few of my favorite YouTubers. So y'all go check out Marcus Rogers' channel. He is a preacher, teacher. He has a message on just about anything that you might be going through. I look at Marcus Rogers a lot. So y'all go check out Marcus Rogers' channel. Also, Kara Lachey has a really, 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 really good workout channel. I think she has 2 workout channels, y'all. So go check out Kara Lachey. And I have been working out with Kara Lachey a little bit for the last maybe a month or so. And I really like doing workouts from home instead of going to the gym. Y'all, I will make so many excuses as to why I'm not going to the gym. I just really don't like, you know, I really don't like that public setting of being at a gym. I'd rather work out at home. So if you have Roku, if you have a smart TV, if you have a Fire Stick, whatever you have, you can look at Kara Lachey videos that's on YouTube from your TV at home, and you can get your workout on. Now, I know her channel was a hip-hop channel, hip-hop workouts. So some of y'all can get down with that, some of y'all can't. So there's another channel that I like as well. It's called Pop Sugar, and that's for working out. And go take a look at their channel and subscribe to their channel, because this video is about good health, and I'm going to touch a little bit on the end times at the end. But y'all, I also did a video on Iaso tea, so I wanted to give y'all a little quick update on that. I know in my video I had like the packages, and there was like these long little skinny packages, and what I did find out was that wasn't the tea that I really needed or whatever, because that instant Iaso tea doesn't have as many herbs in it, and it doesn't have as many benefits to it. So y'all, the package that you need is the one that has the 2 tea bags in it. And that's supposed to help with all type of diseases, supposed to cleanse your body out of toxins. That tea is really like a miracle tea. Everybody's been talking about it. It helps with weight loss. Just so many different things. I think it has like 20 something benefits to it. What you do is you boil some water. You boil water. And you put the 2 tea bags in it, and you let it sit overnight. So you want to cover it up, cover the top of it up, and you let it sit overnight. And if you have like, let's say a gallon of something that had juice in it or whatever, you keep that gallon, because those 2 tea bags make a full gallon of tea, and it's supposed to last you a week. So it's supposed to last you 7 days. And so what you want to do is, after your tea has been sitting overnight, you pour it into that gallon, and you make sure you put the tea bags in there as well, because the tea bags are supposed to stay in that gallon. So y'all, it's Iaso tea, it's spelled I-A-S-O, and what you want is the tea bags. Don't get the instant kind, because the instant kind, it doesn't work as well. It works, but it doesn't work as well for different diseases and different types of things, and also for weight loss, cleansing your body out of toxins. So make sure y'all go out and look up Iaso tea. It's on Amazon, it's on eBay. And also, what I wanted to talk about as well is I was very sick, not this weekend, because this weekend I went on vacation. Y'all, this weekend I had a wonderful weekend. I was in a hotel, and the hotel was just so luxurious. Oh, it had like a restaurant, it had a pool, it had a little bar area, it had a fitness center. It was just a very luxurious hotel. I had a wonderful time this weekend. And what I want to say about last weekend was I was very sick, so I didn't know what was wrong with me. I thought I probably had a sinus infection, because I usually get sinus infections. And I didn't feel like going to the doctor, because I know when I go to the doctor, a lot of times they want to just give me a Z-pack, and Z-packs never really work. They never really help anybody. I don't understand why they keep giving out all of these Z-packs, but I didn't feel like going through that. Sometimes when I go to the doctor's office, like, I refuse to take the Z-pack. I'm like, look, you need to give me an antibiotic. I know myself. I know you're a doctor, but I know myself. I know when I have a sinus infection. I know, because I get those often. And so I was just feeling miserable. I couldn't sleep. My nose was stopped up. My nose was runny. It was just my nose. And then my throat was hurting a little bit. I don't know what all was going on. But I felt pressure right here in my head. So that's when I know, like, I have sinus infection. Because, like, it's just a certain way I feel. And my nose is usually so stopped that I just can't breathe. So what I decided to do was I looked up on the internet, like, home remedies. So I said, I'm going to start getting into home remedies. And I'm going to share this with Diamond Television about home remedies. I feel like everybody should know how to cure themselves of different things. Just in case, you know, you go to the doctor, they don't give you the medicine right away, and you have to go back a second time, and then it just keeps getting crazy. They keep telling you, oh no, you just have a cold, or you have, you know, and nobody wants to go through that. So what I decided to do was to look up like something to make for like sinus infections, or in case it was the flu. So I found out honey helps with a lot of sicknesses. So I put it all together. Also lemon. So in this little drink that I made, had lemon in it, it had garlic, it had cinnamon, and it had honey. When I tell you, I instantly felt so much better. It took about maybe like an hour. I started to notice that I was breathing a little better, and the next day when I woke up, I noticed, you know, I didn't feel as sick. So I kept drinking this little drink that I made, and in 3 days I was better. So I'm not really a person that really believes in home remedies. So for me to do that, I'm like, you know, I'm just like, oh, let me see if this works. Let me see if this works. And it really works. I was amazed by that. And then when I found out that, you know, ginger and garlic are antibiotics, I'm like, I could have been drinking this a long time ago, making whatever this is I'm making. So I just wanted to share that with y'all. So whenever you're feeling sick or whatever, like, I take vitamin C's too. I usually take vitamin C's all winter, give them to my kids. And so now that I discovered that this little drink that I made, like, made me feel a lot better, so I'm gonna start doing that more. Also, because a lot of things are in foods and herbs and stuff that actually heal. I know somebody, a person that had cancer, she would only eat green things like cabbage, greens, kale, and she actually healed herself of cancer. Also, what I want to talk about is a little bit on this end time stuff. Chemtrails. I just learned about chemtrails. I didn't know anything about it. I just looked it up because somebody had been talking about it, and I didn't know anything about that. I had never heard about it. It's spelled C-H-E-M, Trails. Like chem, like short for like chemicals. I was looking at this video on some scientists, and they were talking about how they were concerned about like planes flying across the sky, making like these tic-tac-toe patterns, and how they were spraying chemicals from these planes. And these chemicals, they're not sure what all they are, but they think that they're positive about at least three of them. At least three chemicals they're positive about. So y'all go and look that up, because I don't remember the chemicals that they said, but it's supposed to be killing plants, killing animals on land and in water. They're saying that it's causing fires, that it makes people sick and gives people like different diseases like cancer and different things. So I really don't like talking about this, but I mean, you guys are on my channel, so I have to let y'all know. I have to let y'all know everything. So these chemicals are supposedly making people sick. They're supposedly killing animals. And I don't know a whole lot about chemtrails, but I need y'all to look into that. Also, a little bit about this end times. Bible prophecies have all been playing out, and it's really only a few things that's left to happen. I know that there's one thing in there that really hasn't happened, is the treaty with Israel. I don't think that's happened yet. And also, there's one thing that I really do pay attention to, is the fact that the Bible said people will be lovers of themselves. They're lovers of themselves. Everybody's really into money, material things, and a lot of things that can't help you in the end, because you really can't take money to the grave with you, and you really can't take money with you after you die. So it's just, people are concerned about all the wrong things right now, and instead of being concerned about what they really should be concerned about, is their soul. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and to lose your soul? So then the Bible also talked about that the woman would say, I buy my own food, I take care of myself, I just do everything if I could just have your last name. But just give me your last name, just marry me, I'll take your last name, but I'll take care of myself. Like, that's what's going on these days. And the men aren't really doing their role as men, and things are just kind of weird. So the Bible talked about everything that we're seeing today, and a lot of this end time stuff, y'all, just stay prayed up and just be seeking God. And I know it can get really frustrating. And I know, like, a month ago, I was so angry and I was upset and I didn't know why. And I realized I was upset and I was frustrated because I'm telling people about this end time stuff and they're not really listening to me. They're not really believing me. Like, there's a few people that are around me that, you know, they talk about it with me. They, you know, they talk about it. They know all about it. And so, but when I go out and I tell somebody something that, and they never heard of any of this stuff, you know, they don't really want to listen. They say, oh, well, the end times have been going on for a long time. When, like, the older people used to say, we're in the end times, and we're in the end times. And now that the end times are really here, they're actually here now. And everybody's saying, oh, well, they've been saying that for a while now. They've been saying that. And I'm telling y'all, the end times are here now. So I just want y'all to stay prayed up. And it is true. The fish are dying. Plants are dying. The water is getting more and more polluted all the time with chemicals and different things. And a lot of this food is toxic. Some countries won't even trade food with us Because they say our food is poisonous. They say our food isn't, it isn't good. They say a lot of our food isn't real. I've been looking into that as well. I might do a video on that coming up soon about our food. But y'all, I want y'all to look into it for yourself. I want y'all to look into a lot of these foods that aren't real. They're actually not. So people have been talking about bananas don't taste the same. Some fruits don't taste the same. People have been saying like meat doesn't taste quite right anymore. And what I noticed too when I go to grocery stores is like the meat has like a red dye on it. And I'm like, okay, that doesn't really look like blood. That just looks like it's just dye on this meat or whatever, red dye. And I try to read the labels to everything when I'm at the store. So I read the labels to everything now. And I couldn't understand why older people, that every time you see them, they're in the store and they're looking at these labels and they're taking such a long time in a grocery store. And I understand now, because there's certain things that I won't buy, like certain juices. They have too much corn syrup in it, and they say corn syrup really causes diabetes, and there's too much salt in canned goods. Way more than what we're supposed to intake in a day is found in one little canned good. So I really don't want my diamond gang out there, you know, just eating canned foods, eating things that aren't good for them. I really want to get into making a lot of foods from scratch, showing you how to make different sauces and different things from scratch so that it doesn't contain so much salt. So I'm going to be having some more cooking videos with that, because we got to stay healthy. So garlic powder is an antibiotic. Ginger is an antibiotic. So go to the store, buy you some ginger, buy you some garlic. And also a little bit more on this end times is I've been noticing a lot of these different countries have been making bombs. Like they're making bombs that can travel faster than the speed of sound. Like they're coming up with bombs that are better and better and better. I seen something somewhere where they say Russia is planning to strike America, and where they're planning to strike. So I know I've been saying that for a while, for some years now, that I think that Russia is going to attack America. It's been a lot of prophets that said it. A lot of prophets are saying that World War III is coming. I honestly believe World War III is coming. I know some people that have seen visions of this. They have said, thus said the Lord about this situation, and it's pretty scary. So I want all of y'all to love on your family, love on anybody, love on a stranger, you know, do something nice for somebody today. And I love all of you so very much. I want all of y'all to look into everything that I talked about in this video. Thumbs this video up, like and subscribe, share with a friend, and God bless.